What are the most friends? In previous class, we have seen what about that BACPR theory and hybridization combination, and we have drawn one tabular column. Okay, if you practice the tabular column, whatever the molecule you have, you can find the hybridization, next structure, bond angles easily. But the thing is, you have to do hard work to remember the tabular column. That is very important. Okay. Even yesterday, some questions I gave for your homework. Maximum students, they have done the work and they have sent to my personal number also. Very good. Okay. Only one thing. In that examples, whatever the homework I gave, let us consider NH4+. Let us consider NH4+. NH4+ is called ammonium ion. NH4+ is called ammonium ion. Okay. Under this one, what is the central atom? Central atom is nitrogen. Nitrogen electronic configuration is 1H2, 2H2, 2P3. Nitrogen electronic configuration is 1s2, 2s2, 2p3. In that, what is the outermost shell? Second shell. That second shell has how many electrons? 5 electrons. So, V is equal to 5. Next, M is equal to. What is meant by M? Number of monovalent atoms bonded to the central atom. Number of monovalent atoms bonded to the central atom. Here hydrogen is monovalent because valency of hydrogen is 1, so it comes under monovalent only. Okay, so how many monovalent atoms are bonded? 4 monovalent atoms are bonded. So M is equal to 4. Once again, M is equal to number of monovalent atoms bonded to the central atom. Okay, here 4 hydrogens are bonded to central atom nitrogen, so M is equal to 4. Is it okay? Now the formula is capital H is equal to 1 by 2 into V plus M minus C plus A. Please use this formula. You have to remember this formula, everyone. Okay. What is the formula? Capital H is equal to 1 by 2 into V plus M minus C plus A. What are the terms? V is equal to number of valence electrons present in the central atom. Number of valence electrons present in the central atom. Capital M is equal to number of monovalent atoms bonded to the central atom. C means, if it is cation, numerical value present on that cation. Here this is cation only. What is the numerical value? 1. Okay, capital A, when we have to use the capital A? When it is anion. But here we have no anion, so no need to use this A. Is it okay, ma? Now V, M, okay. C is equal to how much? C is equal to 1, because here no value is there. If no value is there, we have to write 1 in numerator. In numerator, no value is there, simply we wrote plus only. Plus is nothing but plus 1. All the values we got. Now do this one. Capital H is equal to A is equal to 0. It is not belonging to anion, so automatically capital A is equal to 0. Okay. H is equal to 1 by 2 into V value 5 plus M value 4, C value 1 minus 1 is equal to 1 by 2 into 5 plus 4, 9. 9 minus 1, 8 is equal to 4. If H is equal to 4, hybridization is sp3. If H is equal to 4, hybridization is sp3. Okay. How to find the lone pairs, number of lone pairs? Very simple. What is the H value we are getting? 4. We got H is equal to 4. In the formula, how many hydrogens are present? 4. both the numbers are same or not? Both the numbers are same. If both the numbers are same, loan base will be 0. Do one thing, this value minus this value you can do. H value is equal to 4 we got, 4 minus 4, 0. Number of loan pays equal to 0. So, number of loan pays is equal to 0. Number of loan pays equal to 0. Hybridization is SP3. Then, according to the table column, model will be AB4 with no loan pays. If the model is AB4, immediately shape will be tetrahedral. Immediately shape will be tetrahedral, bond angle 109 degrees, 28 minutes. Slowly I took very time and I explained the tabular column. Tabular column, which means I have given SP hybridization. Example, SP2, under that SP2 models, AB3, AB2E, like that models. Again, under SP3 hybridization models, like that slowly, very slowly, I have completed the table column. Please go through the table column keenly, neatly. Okay, if you are very perfect with the table column, immediately by getting this model, okay, we will get understood what about the shape and bond angle easily, very easy. I hope you understood how to get this NH4 plus hybridization. NH4 plus hybridization is SP3. Okay, shape tetrahedral, bond angle 109 degrees, 28 minutes. All these we wrote because it comes under the model AB4. It comes under the model AB4. Like this, I give one more ion, BF4 minus. That one also I will explain and we will go to next topic now. Is it okay? I hope you are clear about this explanation. Next we will see what about the BF4 minus also. Next one more thing I ask, that is BF4 minus. It carries which charge? Positive charge or negative charge? Negative charge. Then it is coming under anion. Anion means in the formula we require capital A only. C value 0. If it is cation, C value will be there. If it is anion, capital A value will be there. Okay. Both the values at a time it is not possible because in the world, okay, no species which carries positive charge and negative charge at a time. Okay ma? Now, what are the values we want? First, what is the central atom? Central atom is boron. Boron electronic configuration 1s2, 2s2, 2p1. What is outermost shell, second shell? In that, how many electrons are there? 3. Then, V is equal to 3. Is it okay all of you? Capital V is equal to number of valence electrons present in the central atom. Okay. In this central atom, how many valence electrons are present? 3. Capital V is equal to 3. Next. Fluorine is monovalent because atomic number of fluorine is 9. Nearest inert gas, neon. To get the neon configuration, fluorine wants one electron. Then its valency will be 1 only. By using how many electrons, that means by losing or by gaining or by sharing, whatever it might be, by using how many electrons it is involved in bonding, okay, that is called valency. Fluorine will be involved in bonding by using one electron. So valency is equal to 1. So it is monovalent only. Capital M is equal to number of monovalent atoms bonded to the central atom. Number of monovalent atoms bonded to the central atom. How many monovalent atoms are bonded to central atom? 4. M is equal to 4. Next, C is equal to 0. Why? It is not cation, it is anion. If it is anion, C value will be 0 only. Okay, next, A value. A is equal to numerical value present on anion. Capital A is equal to numerical value present on anion. This is anion. Minus is there. If minus is there, numerical value 1. Minus 1, numerical value 1. Charge minus. Okay. So A is equal to 1. These are the four values in our formula. Immediately I am going to write the formula. Capital H is equal to 1 by 2 into V plus M minus C plus A. V plus C, V plus M minus C plus A. Okay. Is equal to 1 by 2 into, what is the V value? 3 plus capital M value 4 minus 0, C value 0. A is equal to 1 plus 1 is equal to 1 by 2 into 3 plus 4, 7 plus 1, 8. 8 by 2. 8 by 2 is equal to 4. If it is 4, okay, what is the hybridization? Hybridization is sp3. Now we want to know lone pairs. To find the lone pairs, previously what is the method I told? See, what is the H value? 4. And see this value also. Central atom is bonded to how many atoms? Here we should not consider anything. Simply see the number. Okay, man? Central atom is bonded to how many atoms? 4. 4 minus 4? 0. So, 0 lone pairs. H value 4. Hybridization sp3. Okay. Lone pairs 0. It comes under the model AB4. Same model. Previously, what is the model we got? Same model. AB4. AB4 means all 4 are bond pairs only. Lone pairs are 0. Okay. AB4 means immediately shape. Tetrahedral. Bond angle 109 degrees, 28 minutes. Bond angle 109 degrees, 28 minutes. This is the information about BF4 minus. Okay, next we will see PCl3 also. Before that, Saravan Kannan, he asked one doubt, that is, how this BF4 minus is formed, sir? Even NH4 plus also. Okay, to explain these molecules, we have to complete coordinate covalent bond. Okay, for reference purpose, I am telling, initially, types of chemical bonds I told 3 types. Those are first one ionic bond, second one covalent bond, and third one coordinate covalent bond. First we have completed ionic bond entirely, properties, everything we completed. Second, we are going through covalent bond. We did not complete that one. One more theory is there, molecular orbital theory. By that only we are going to complete covalent bond. Third one is there now, that is coordinate covalent bond. After completion of the covalent bond, coordinate covalent bond only, we will come across how this BF4 minus is formed. At the time of explanation of coordinate covalent bond, I will explain that one. No problem. Okay. Very good doubt only you got. The thing is, if you know coordinate covalent bond, then easily we can understand. For explaining the structure BF4 minus bond, definitely I will explain at the time of coordinate covalent bond formation. Is it okay? Now this is about BF4 minus. Next we will see what about PCl3. Phosphorus trichloride. Okay. Let us see that one. PCl3. In PCl3, what is the central atom? Central atom is phosphorus. Electronic configuration of phosphorus is 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p3. This is the electronic configuration of phosphorus. I observed the question papers, answer scripts, term 1 answer scripts. Some students, they wrote very drastically electronic configurations. Major number of students, they wrote nicely. Okay. Some students, I did not remember the names, but they made mistakes in this electronic configuration. Please once go through once again Mohler's diagram. Okay. After that, how electrons will be filled? Bohr's rule. After that, Hund's rule is applied for same energy orbitals. Remember them. Any doubts are there, you can ask me, no problem. But the thing is, you have to be clear about that concept. Okay, now phosphorus electronic configuration is okay. What is the outermost shell in phosphorus? Third shell. In the third shell, how many electrons are there? 5 electrons are there. So V is equal to 5. Okay, no? V is equal to 5. M is equal to number of monovalent atoms bonded to central atom. Capital M is equal to number of monovalent atoms bonded to central atom. Chlorine is monovalent only. How many monovalent atoms are bonded to central atom? 3. Chlorine's number 3. So M is equal to 3. Next. A is equal to 0, C is equal to 0. Why? The given molecule does not carry any charge. Positive charge or negative charge is not present. It is neutral molecule. When it is neutral molecule, C value cation charge as well as anion charge, both are 0 only. So A value 0, C value 0 I wrote. Okay. Now all the 4 values we have, substitute in the given formula. Capital H is equal to 1 by 2 into V plus M minus C plus A is equal to 1 by 2 into, what is the V value? 5 plus, what is the M value? 3. Okay, close this bracket because these two are 0 only. Next, 8 by 2, 4. 4 means if H is equal to 4, it comes under hybridization sp3. But to explain the structure or to say the structure name, we have to know the model, whether it is AB4, AB3E or AB2E2. Okay, to understand that, first we have to know lone pairs. Seema, what is the H value we got? 4. How many atoms are bonded to phosphorus? 3. 4 minus 3? 1. This value minus that value only we have to do. 4 minus 3? 1. So we got 1 lone pair. Lone pair is equal to 1. If lone pair is equal to 1 and 3 bond pairs are there, it comes under model AB3E. Once observe the table column, if the model is AB3E, then shape will be pyramidal. Shape will be trigonal pyramidal. Immediately bond angle 107 degrees. That is the information about PCl3. Then immediately we will write one lone pair on phosphorus. But at the time of giving the name of formula, they will not mention that lone pair. That's why if you know this formula, it is easy for us to give the structure. It is very easy for us to give the structure. Please understand the value of this formula. This formula will not be given in your CBSE textbook. It is dealt in NEET or IIT only. Okay. So whatever the problem if they give, we can solve with the help of this formula. That is the thing. Chemical bond, already I told, it is very important not only for CBSE, it is important for NEET and IIT also. In NEET, sometimes we can expect 5 questions. Out of 5 questions, 2 questions might be asked from structures. By using this formula only accurately we can find. Otherwise, very difficult to understand the question also. Okay, please understand the importance, ma'am. Now, PCl3 I told, BF4 minus I told, even one more thing, that is NH4 plus. Okay, that NH4 plus BF4 minus structures, I will explain at the time of coordinate covalent bond explanation also. Okay, this is about the homework I gave in previous class. Now, we will see what about the next concept in our covalent bond only. Okay, we did not complete the covalent bond. In covalent bond, valence bond theory was completed, hybridization was completed, even VSEPR theory was also completed. We are going to study MOT. But before going to study that MOT, we have to know why that MOT came into existence. Came into existence means why that MOT was established. That is the thing we have to know. Okay, that one I am going to explain. Before that, I hope that everyone understood this procedure and what way we have done the shape and everything. If you are very perfect with this model, then we can understand this shape easily. For that, I gave the table column. The table column neatly, those who have written and those who practice correctly, for them definitely identification of these structures will be easy only. There is no difficult at all. Okay, ma'am. Now, let us see that. What are the drawbacks present in hybridization? What are the drawbacks present in hybridization? Okay, before that, what is the main point explained in hybridization? Hybridization successfully explains the structures of molecules according to our experimental data. According to experimental data, what is the information we are getting? By using that hybridization, we are getting same information. That's why this is the successful theory to explain the structures of molecules. Okay, along with VSEPR theory, it explains the structures of molecules and bond angles along with everything clearly. 100% correct only. But the problem is, magnetic properties like that, one property is there. Okay. What is that now? Magnetic properties. Okay. Magnetic properties of molecules were not explained by hybridization. Only magnetic properties. And stability of very less number of molecules, stability of rare molecules, not less, stability of rare molecules. I will say at the time of molecular theory, we will come across what are those rare molecules also, no problem. Okay, see, magnetic properties and stability of very rare molecules were not explained by hybridization and VSEPR theory. Magnetic properties and stability of very rare molecules were not explained by hybridization and VSEPR theory. What are those magnetic properties? Okay, what are those rare molecules? All these things in next theory we will see. Before that, this is the main one drawback which comes under hybridization and VSEPR theory. To overcome this drawback, scientists proposed one more theory called molecular orbital theory, MOT. What is that? Molecular orbital theory, which is called MOT. By using that MOT, we can explain the magnetic properties of molecules, okay, and even stability of some rare molecules neatly. To explain these two only, MOT is useful. To explain the structures, MOT is not needed, because to explain the structures, already we have taken the help hybridization and VSEPR theory. So what are the partial properties not explained by hybridization and VSEPR theory? Those are only taken under molecular orbital theory. Okay, so before going to that molecular orbital theory, we have to know what are these magnetic properties. Is it okay? Now let us start with that one. Once again, I am telling, to explain the magnetic properties and stability of some rare molecules, new theory was proposed, that is called molecular orbital theory, which is MOT. Okay, ma'am? Now let us see what about magnetic properties. By using these magnetic properties, substances will be classified into, actually, 1 minute more, I will tell clearly, substances will be classified into three types. Depending on these magnetic properties, substances will be classified into three types. Diamagnetic substances, paramagnetic substances, ferromagnetic substances. Diamagnetic substances, paramagnetic substances and ferromagnetic substances. Okay, strictly speaking, in your 12th class you have one chapter called solid state. Okay, in that solid state totally 5 are there. Under this magnetic properties, totally 5 types are there. At that time we will see, that is not that much important. Okay, out of these 3 also we will concentrate on 2 only. That one also neatly I will tell. But before that, once again, before writing this one, observe the point, write the point all of you, that is, depending on magnetic properties, write this point, depending on magnetic properties, okay, substances are classified into 3 types. Depending on magnetic properties, substances are classified into 3 types. Those are diamagnetic substances, paramagnetic substances, ferromagnetic substances. What are those 3? Diamagnetic substances, paramagnetic substances, ferromagnetic substances. Okay. The property of the diamagnetic substances, the property of the diamagnetic substances is called diamagnetism. The property of the diamagnetic substances is called diamagnetism. The property of the paramagnetic substances is called paramagnetism. The property of the ferromagnetic substances is called ferromagnetism. Property of the ferromagnetic substances is called ferromagnetism. Once again, the property of the diamagnetic substances is called diamagnetism. The property of the paramagnetic substances is called paramagnetism. The property of the ferromagnetic substances is called ferromagnetism. Okay, now coming to the definition of diamagnetism, paramagnetism and ferromagnetism. Okay, now the substance which is weakly repelled by the magnet. Substance which is weakly repelled by the magnet is called diamagnetic substance. The substance which is weakly repelled by the magnet is called diamagnetic substance. Okay, one small thing is, I have one substance in my hand. Whether you brought north pole of the magnet or south pole of the magnet near to the substance, there is small repulsion between these two. Then that substance is called diamagnetic substance. Okay, one small thing. Suppose two magnets are there. Two magnets, north poles, if you keep nearby, repulsion we will observe in our hand. Is it correct or not? Like that repulsion we will observe here between substance and magnet. Between substance and magnet. That is weakly repelled. The substance which is weakly repelled by the magnet is called diamagnetic substance. Once again, and that property is called diamagnetism. The substance which is weakly repelled by the magnet is called diamagnetism, and that property is, sorry, diamagnetic substance, and that property is called diamagnetism. Sir, by seeing the molecule or by doing some calculations, how can we say that substance is diamagnetic substance? It is very simple. These diamagnetic substances do not contain unpaired electrons. These diamagnetic substances do not contain unpaired electrons. Observe this point carefully, all of you. We will note down that substance, we will write the electronic configuration. After writing the electronic configuration, if you observe any unpaired electron, then diamagnetic substance, it is not diamagnetic. if it does not contain unpaired electron, if the substance does not contain unpaired electron, that means all are paired electrons, no single electron must be there. Electron singly it should not be there. All the electrons which are present must be paired. Then that substance is called diamagnetic substance. Is it okay, ma'am? Once again, what is meant by diamagnetic substance? The substance which will weakly repelled by the magnet, which will be weakly repelled by the magnet. The substance which will be weakly repelled by the magnet is called diamagnetic substance, and that property is called diamagnetism. To identify the diamagnetic substance easily, we have to see whether that substance contains unpaired electron or not. If that substance does not contain unpaired electron, then that substance is diamagnetic substance. At the time we are taking examples, you will understand. No problem. First thing is you have to remember these definitions. Okay. Now, what about paramagnetic substance? Substance which is weakly attracted by the magnet. Substance which is weakly attracted by the magnet is called paramagnetic substance, and that property is called paramagnetism. Okay, then to understand this one, this substance must contain one or two unpaired electrons. This substance must contain one or two unpaired electrons. This substance do not contain any unpaired electrons. This substance must contain one or two unpaired electrons. Coming to ferromagnetism, substance which is strongly attracted by the magnet. Substance which is strongly attracted by the magnet is called ferromagnetic substance. Substance which is strongly attracted by the magnet is called ferromagnetic substance, and that property is called ferromagnetism. So this substance must contain greater than two unpaired electrons. This substance must contain greater than 2, that means 3 unpaired electrons, 4 unpaired electrons, 5 unpaired electrons. If that substance has these many, 3, 4, 5 unpaired electrons, then those substances are coming under ferromagnetism, ferromagnetic substances, and that property is called ferromagnetism. Once again, depending on magnetic properties, substances are classified into 3 types: diamagnetic substance, paramagnetic substance, as well as ferromagnetic substance. Diamagnetic substance is weakly repelled by the magnet, which do not contain unpaired electrons. Single electron must not be there. Okay. Coming to paramagnetic substance, paramagnetism, the property is called paramagnetism. Substances which are weakly attracted by the magnet are called paramagnetic substances, and the property is called paramagnetism. Okay. Examples, if you want, that examples will be covered in the molecular orbital theory. No problem. You will get so many examples. No need to bother about that one. I will take care of that one. Now coming under ferromagnetic substances. Substance which is strongly attracted by the magnet is called ferromagnetic substance, and it must contain, that substance must contain greater than two unpaired electrons. Okay. Now next coming topic, molecular orbital theory. We will go through only diamagnetic and paramagnetic only. Maximum ferromagnetic till that extent we will not go through. we will see only diamagnetic and paramagnetic substances only. But anyways, we got the definition here itself. If you want, you can note down and remember carefully. It will be useful in solid state in next year, 12th class. Okay, ma'am. These properties, suppose example, oxygen is there, O2. Okay, O2 naturally it is paramagnetic. It should be weakly attracted by the magnet. O2 nature is paramagnetic. Practically it is proved. It should be weakly attracted by the magnet. But according to valence bond theory and hybridization and everything, it does not contain any unpaired electron. So it should be diamagnetic. But we have to believe experimental data. Experimentally it is showing that O2 is paramagnetic. But hybridization, every explanation, it is giving that O2 is diamagnetic. We have to believe experimental data, na? That's why O2 nature, magnetic nature, remaining everything okay. O2 magnetic nature was not successfully explained by valence bond theory or hybridization or VACPR theory. That's why by using molecular orbital theory, we can explain the magnetic nature of O2 also correctly. Like not only O2, remaining some more molecules are there, we will explain those magnetic properties and stability is also very correctly by using molecular orbital theory. Is it okay, ma'am? Now, I am going to keep the side heading, that is MOT. Okay, let us see. But magnetic properties, this is the information. Depending on magnetic properties, substances are classified into three types. But in our topic, we are going through only two types, diamagnetic and paramagnetic only. Is it okay, ma'am? Now let us see. Molecular orbital theory. Before that, if we use hybrid orbitals, that theory is called hybridization. If you use molecular orbitals, that is called molecular orbital theory. So, in hybridization, how did we discuss hybrid orbitals are involved in bonding? Like that, here we are going to discuss molecular orbitals are going to be involved in bonding. Okay, but to understand this molecular orbital concept, okay, little bit basics are required. Those basics I am going to discuss now. Wave characteristics also we have to consider now. Okay, so introduction of this molecular orbital theory is, let us consider electron is moving in the form of wave. Electron is moving in the form of wave. Okay, now let us represent this wave with a letter called psi. Let us represent this wave, means total electron wave. This is one electron, he is moving in the form of wave, crest and trough. Okay, that is represented by the letter psi, pronunciation psi, S-Y-E, psi. Okay, let us consider this is the wave which is represented as psi A. What is that? Psi A. Next, one more wave I am going to consider. This is another electron. Another electron is moving in the form of wave. This is represented by Psi B. Another wave, that is Psi B. Okay, now what is going to be happen? Observe this, man, all of you. These two waves are going to meet. These two waves are going to meet. Suppose, see, this is the direction of one wave. This is the direction of another wave. These two are coming and going to meet. One example I am going to tell. Okay, let us say, I am sitting here and I am talking. When I am talking with you, one student, one in front of me, you are sitting, suppose. okay, I am a teacher, I am standing here and I am talking with you. While I am talking with you, when I talk or when I start my speech, immediately sound waves are coming. From my mouth, sound waves are coming. Those sound waves are traveling in the form of crust and trough, and they will reach towards you without any disturbance. Correct? Then what will be happened? So they are audible to you clearly. But what is going to be happened? Along with me, one more teacher is standing here. Adjacent to me itself, one more teacher is standing. Even he is also talking at a time. Both of us, at a time we are talking. Then what is going to happen? From me, sound waves are coming. Even from this teacher also, sound waves are coming. Those two are going to meet. That meeting is called interference. What is that? Interference. Sound waves from one teacher and another teacher are going to be interfered. That means combined. When they are combined and they are going to reach towards you, both the waves are not correctly reached towards you. They are combined, so disturbance will be happened. That's why at a time, if two persons are talking, we cannot listen to any one person clearly. We cannot listen to any one person clearly. Because there is going to be interfered. Interfered means interference. The process is called interference, and that process is called combination, which is called interference. Are you understanding? No? That interference is of two types. That interference is of two types. Those two are constructive interference and destructive interference. Interference is nothing but combination of two waves. Once again, interference is nothing but combination of two waves. Interference is of two types. Those are constructive interference and destructive interference. Constructive interference and destructive interference. Okay, so how constructive interference will be formed and how destructive interference will be formed, we will see in next class. After knowing that constructive interference and destructive interference, then we will have some idea about this wave nature and how molecular orbitals will be formed. Like this is the basic term related to molecular orbital theory. Okay, ma. Once again, I am repeating. Electron is represented in the form of wave. Electron movement is represented in the form of wave, and that representation is psi A. Another electron movement is represented in the form of psi B. Those two waves can be interfered in two ways. One is called constructive interference and another one is called destructive interference. The process of combination of these two waves will be called as interference, and interference is of two types, constructive interference and destructive interference. What is meant by constructive interference and what is meant by destructive interference, we will see in next class. Okay, I hope today's class it is very clear for you. So today's class, I will recall that one. What are the topics we have completed? We have seen how can we explain the structures and bond angles present in NH4 plus, BF4 minus, and even PCl3 also I have explained. After completion of that, we have to go through molecular orbital theory. But before that, why this molecular orbital theory is existed? Because this hybridization and BSEPR theory could not explain the magnetic properties and stabilities of some rare molecules clearly. Okay, but experimental data one thing, and according to this hybridization we are getting another information. So to explain the magnetic properties and stability of some rare molecules, a new theory is going to be proposed, that is called molecular orbital theory, which is MOT. Okay, to know that MOT, first we have to know what is meant by magnetic substance. Magnetic substance are of three types. Depending on those magnetic properties, substances are classified into three types. Those three are diamagnetic substances, paramagnetic substances, and ferromagnetic. But in our topic, we will go through only diamagnetic and paramagnetic. Is it okay? Iron will be attracted by magnet, but plastic is not attracted by magnet. Depending on that, we classify three types. Okay, this is about today's class. Now, in next class, we will see what is meant by that constructive inference and what is meant by the destructive inference. Okay, I hope today's class is very clear for you. Thank you. Have a nice day. Thank you all.